final fight of this evening. It's the title fight between South Africa and Thailand. Chalk, this fight begins. Thai boy seems very relaxed right now.
I think it's great to see a fight with this level of experience, the guys in the first couple of rounds.
And you can see the skill and the power that the Thai boy has. Kong Krai, fast kicks, seems super relaxed. Hair's done. Remember, he is the current champion as well, so Jared's got to step up to the plate, right, Joe, if he wants to win this fight. Jared landing a good punch there to the midsection, but Kong Krai not really too fazed.
Yeah, I love watching the Thai fighters. They've got such an amazing spirit in the ring. Yeah, this is life for these guys. It's their national sport. They take so much enjoyment out of this. Obviously, all the hard work goes in.
So relaxed and so in control. Jared doing really well, landing some good kicks as well. Jared throwing those elbows. And a little bit of a technique there where the rule is in Muay Thai, you may not punch the fighter as when he's on the ground, but between the air and the ground, he's not on the ground yet, so you often see the Thai fighters throwing a sneaky punch on the way down.
I certainly saw that sneaky maneuver going in there, but Jared looking none the worse for wear.
Great kick there to the midsection from Jared, and a good block there as well from him.
Oh, great teep from Jared there, finding his home right into the solar plexus of Kong Krai.
These two fighters exchanging kicks, exchanging punches. They both look very relaxed. They both look in control of the fight at the moment. So I know Jared's extremely fit, and hopefully that fitness will carry him through the fight. Landing a good knee there as well. Maybe he's going to be able to turn the fight, jam. Remember, these Thais are also deadly in the grapple, so you need to watch out and don't allow any opportunity or give any gap.
Oh, that was a great exchange there from both fighters.
Jared really stepping up to the plate now. Good, throwing some good knees there as well. And that's the foul singing the end of the first round. And remember, Rob, this fight is scheduled for 5 rounds of 3 minutes a round. They will have a 2-minute break now to basically get the breath back, get a bit of coaching from their corners, see where they're going wrong, see what they're doing right. And but remember, this is a 5-round fight, 3 minutes a round. It's a long time to be fighting.
Yeah, you have to be in supreme condition to go all 5 rounds. Stepping into the ring is no easy thing, but to do it for 5 rounds is a long haul. Obviously, these guys have been putting in extra hours at the gym. They know exactly what's coming. Long just giving his fighter a rub down on the legs. He's looking extremely relaxed. Lots of smiles coming out of there. He's not puffing any big breaths. Jared looking very relaxed as well.
Absolutely, both these fighters looking strong still. I know Jared is super fit, so I don't think fitness is going to be an issue for him in this fight. It's just going to be whether he can actually stand up and stand toe-to-toe with this Thai right until the end, because these guys are so strong.
Yeah, this is what it's all about. What a great night of action from Dragon Power Promotions. Ultimate fight night tonight at Grand West Arena. Such a pleasure to have been involved in all the fights tonight.
Absolutely, and I spoke to Jared earlier as well, and he wants his belt more than anything. And he's worked so hard for it. So I don't know that South Africa is behind him.
Every time I've been in the gym and you see Jared train, it's inspirational. The guy doesn't stop.
Hands up, Jared, make sure.
left kick there from Jared the Rottweiler.
Followed up with some strong knees.
Fantastic knees as well. Putting his opponent straight back into the ropes. Kunkrai looking a little bit angry now.
Yeah, there's no more smiles coming out of him.
That strong kick there from Kunkrai again, and Kunkrai looking for that elbow, just missing it as well.
So strong in the grapple,
Jared's
is Kunkrai.
Yeah, absolutely, but Jared's also landing some great knees, so, you know, very even with these two fighters.
Yeah, both fighters scoring good points in the grapple and in the kicks. Nice combos there from both fighters. Strong defense from Kunkrai.
Not there from Kunkrai, almost acknowledging to Jared that he landed a good solid punch. Man, I tell you what, Rob, you can actually hear and almost feel the blows from these two fighters. The energy inside this ring is intense.
You can cut this atmosphere with a knife. No one's giving an inch in this ring.
The crowd is on the edge of their seat. I think the crowd is a lot more nervous than even Jared is right now. They just want Jared to win this fight, and it's such a hard fighter that he's up against. But looking so good is Jared the Rottweiler. Landing a good jab there.
Good block there from Jared. And landing a solid lift.
Jared also looking angry. He wants this so badly. And he doesn't stop coming. He keeps on going forward all the time.
Jared certainly looking like he's taking the upper hand in round two here.
And that's the end of the second round. What what an atmosphere. What a fight so far. And the Thai looks angry. Jared looks angry and more determined than he ever has.
Well, this crowd of 2,500 people here at the arena and everyone watching at home on Zuffi has sure been treated to the first two rounds. What spectacular Muay Thai this has been.
Man, you can actually, the sweat is flashing onto us over here. This is absolute intense. When we're watching this fight, almost forgetting to talk, Rob. This is such an incredibly intense fight. Crowd loving it. We loving it. Our tables await.
Fortunately, not with the blood out of Jared's either. He's been opened up above his right eye. Marlon sending him into the corner there.
Yeah, that looks like quite a deep gash, but Quentin putting a little bit of Vaseline, pushing it into the wound. But that's the way these Thais are. They're exceptionally hard, and he'll know that his eyes are open now, and he'll be probably working that area.
Yeah, for sure. So by no fault of Jared's, it's a weakness that has been exposed, and now he's just got to make sure that
the first blood of the night, and this is in the main fight.
Jared getting stuck straight back in there. Some solid kicks and punches flying in there.
Good, Jared.
Joe still landing a few punches as well to the midsection, but not really hurting the tie at all. Jared's at a bit of a psychological disadvantage, but not showing it at all. He's still pushing exceptionally hard. Jared nodding to say, listen man, I'm still in the fight.
I think Conkry responding to that quite well. He certainly knows that Jared's still in this fight and hasn't given anything up.
That cut starting to bleed a little bit on Jared. Ty looking angry, but taking a few good hard shots there to the midsection, and Jared scoring a good couple of points.
He stands right up into it.
Jared landing a good punch there as well.
I think Jared's doing exceptionally well, keeping the distance close between him and Conkry.
Jared definitely on the front foot. We got the tie on the back foot and just missing a big elbow there. That would have been lights out for Conkry if Jared landed that elbow.
And Conkry looking a little bit unsteady on his feet after that last exchange.
Landing a good shot there to the head. And this is where Conkry could be dangerous, back in the grapple. Jared puts Conkry to the ground, and I think this is where the fitness of Jared is going to come through as well. And that's the bell signaling the end of round three. And what an amazing round it was. We just got to see some blood. And I think that didn't take anything away from Jared at all. We've got him coming back so strong in the rounds. And Conkry looked like he may be tiring a little bit at the end. This is probably an opportunity for Jared to push. There's two rounds left of this fight. Anything can happen. So,
Jared's eye being opened up there, but I think that's the only thing we can take away from him there. And he really came out fighting after that little section with Sifu rubbing some Vaseline into him. He certainly looked like he took that round.
A good left kick there from Jared. See, now this is round four. Now generally in round four is when the ties actually wake up, so it'll be quite interesting to see if Conkry has the fitness to pull this off. Jared's still looking exceptionally strong, throwing some good knees, good low kick there as well. Jared landing good two kicks in a row there as well. That'll be hurting Conkry's leg.
Another kick on the way down there. Of course, he's still in the air, he's fair game.
Don Marlin just wiping the sweat off the ring there a little bit. And let the fighters start again. Fighters are back into the grapple against the ropes. Marlon might separate the two if they stay against the rope for too long, but they switch positions. It looks like this grapple is going to continue. Fighters go back into the corner as well. This atmosphere is so intense. We're both watching this fight with bated breath. Obviously, the two of us, we definitely are behind Jared. We want him to win. We are South African, and naturally, we want him to win this fight. And but we've got this Thai fighter who's typically Thai in the way that he's fighting, and so super strong. Oh, and Jared just missing a huge kick there.
Jared's certainly showing amazing dexterity, staying on his feet in a few of these exchanges. The Thai trying to overpower him and drag him down. Jared keeping both their bodies up effectively.
And they go back into the grapple in the corner. I really do think that Khun Krai is getting tired now. And if there's an opportunity for Jared, this is it. He needs to get in there, he needs to knock his opponent out. And that's the end of the fourth round. I would say Jared is probably ahead on points right now, but anything can happen. We've got one round of 3 minutes to go. So what an intense fight, what an intense atmosphere. This is what everybody's come here this evening to watch.
Yeah, this is the last 3 minutes. And anything can change here. I agree with you guys. I think Jared is slightly ahead on points. But he's got to keep his composure. Keep scoring the points for another 3 minutes or go for a knockout. I think he's missing an opportunity a little bit with Khun Krai. Keeps dropping his hands towards the end of the exchanges. If Jared just closed the distance, landed one or two punches, could mean the difference.
This is what it comes down to. The final round of the... this world title fight between South Africa and Thailand. Some lady love. I thought we only see that in the girls' fights, but start with a hug and end with a wall.
Whoa, some great kicks shown in there from Khun Krai.
Oh, some different level of fighting. And that was Khun Krai almost coming straight through the ropes onto us over here.
Oh, strong overhand from Jared.
What an intense round. This has stepped up to another level completely.
Khun Krai there jumping off both of his knees to land the knees into Jared. Both fighters giving it their all.
Jared with a flurry of punches there. Khun Krai looking tired again, gritting his teeth. But both of these fighters want it so badly.
Jeez, this is intense. I've never seen a fight like this. It's amazing skills being shown by both fighters.
Jared definitely showing that he's got what it takes to be one of the best fighters in the world. He is going up against a fighter with an unbelievable amount of experience.
Jared landing some good knees and elbows in this final exchange. This must be getting toward the end of the fight. These guys have got to give it everything in these last couple of seconds.
That's it, Rob. We've only got a few seconds left in this fight. And it's still firing away with some huge kicks there from Jared. This has turned into a war. Jared giving absolutely everything he's got. I can hear him from here. He's putting so much into this fight. He wants it so badly. What an amazing throw. We're putting Khun Krai down to the canvas.
And that's
the end of round five. My gosh, what a fight. Absolutely incredible.
The stadium is off their feet.
Your winner and new International Muay Thai Against Drugs middleweight champion, Gerard the Rottweiler.
If you want to do it, if you want to do anything in life, just go for it, because there was a time I was going in a complete different path, but my childhood dream was to become a world champion. So if you've got any dream, you go for it. No one can hold you back. It's your life, and you talk it into existence. You tell yourself, I'm going to be the best that I can be. Not the best that there ever was, but the best that you can be. You can't expect any more than that.